Hi there, my name is Swarup Krishnamurthy and I'm a program manager on the Azure AD engineering team.
Hi there, my name is Martin Kutzer. I'm also a program manager on the Azure AD engineering team. Today we're going to look at choosing the right authentication method for your Azure AD solution for your organization.
So why is choosing the right authentication method so important? First, it is the first decision that you make on your journey to the cloud. When you're trying to deploy apps such as Office 365, cloud applications, or even line of business applications, you need to decide how your users will actually sign in and access applications. Second, it is the foundation of your modern IT infrastructure, on top of which you'll build your security, identity, and access management solution using Azure AD. Third, once you actually choose your authentication method, it is hard to change because it will likely disrupt your user sign-in experience. Azure AD supports many authentication options to meet the requirements of all types of organizations. The first option is cloud only. This is for the born-in-cloud organizations with no on-premises infrastructure. Here, you can establish user identities directly in the cloud, and Azure AD handles all of the authentications completely in the cloud. Now, all the other options required an on-premises Active Directory. We call this hybrid identity. Now, the second option is password hash sync. In this case, users can actually sign in to cloud-based applications using the same usernames and passwords that they use with their on-premises Active Directory. In addition, password hash sync also provides user and password protection. Seamless single sign-on is a complementary feature. We'll talk about that a little bit later on in this video. Password authentication is the third option. It is very similar to password hash sync, but it's for organizations where their security policies are something that they would like to reuse in the cloud. The next two options are federated authentication. It can be either using Microsoft's ADFS or third-party compatible federation providers. In this case, Azure AD actually hands off the authentication to a trusted authentication system to handle all of the authentication. Federated authentication is the best fit for organizations which need advanced requirements that are not natively supported in Azure AD.
This decision tree will make it easier for you to choose the right authentication method for your organization. You can use it to determine what is the best method by answering a few simple questions. Let's explore a few examples with this decision tree. Let's take Wingtip Toys. Wingtip Toys is an online retailer for toys they manufacture. Today, they use a simple email system from their internet provider, and they want to use Microsoft Teams to collaborate around new projects. Since they don't have an on-premises footprint, cloud only is the right option for them. They will create and manage new users and passwords in Azure AD directly. This will allow them to use Microsoft Teams and extend their applications to other Office 365 apps and even other cloud apps that is available.
Now, next up is Fabricam. They're a widget manufacturing company and have been making widgets over the last 30 years. They have more than 7,000 factory workers who sign into Active Directory every day to do their jobs. Now, Fabricam has decided to deploy Workday, an HR cloud-based application, to let factory workers handle their payroll online, and also to migrate to Office 365 so that these factory workers can actually receive their work schedules over email. It is important that the Fabricam's factory workers use the same usernames and passwords that they use today with Active Directory also to sign into Workday and Office 365. It lets them stay productive, and also Fabricam's help desk costs are kept under control. In addition, Fabricam doesn't have a large IT department, so they need the simplest solution possible, which actually means the lowest on-prem footprint and also low operating costs. Password hash sync seems to be the right solution for them. Here's how password hash sync works. First, you install Azure AD Connect, our provisioning tool, to actually provision users from on-premises Active Directory into Azure AD, and you also enable password hash sync as your sign-in option. Now, on-premises Active Directory never stores passwords in clear text, but in hash form. A hash is the value that you get from a one-way mathematical function applied on a clear text password. There is no method to reverse a hash to get back the clear text password. Now, Azure AD connects to the on-premises Active Directory and reads these password hashes, hashes them 1,000 times over, and then copies them over to Azure AD. And it does this process every 2 minutes. Now, when the user is actually trying to sign into Azure AD, they plug in their username and password into Azure AD. We apply the same hashing algorithms as I described before, and then we compare the username and the hashed value and try to match it with the username and the stored hash value in Azure AD. If there is a match, then the user is successfully signed in. As you can see, during authentication, there is no dependency on the on-premises infrastructure. Password hashing also provides a couple of key security benefits. First among them is this report that we call leak credential reports. The way that works is Microsoft scans the internet, especially the dark web, for usernames and password lists that have been leaked to the wild. It then, if it finds any matches to your users' accounts, it'll actually alert your administrators through a leak credential reports, or it'll automatically block users for signing in, or maybe even allowing them to reset their password the next time they actually sign in. This feature is only possible if you use password hash sync. Second, a feature called smart lockout is also applicable here. This actually protects brute force password attacks in the cloud and prevents genuine users from being locked out of their applications. Now, you should combine password hash sync with this complementary feature called seamless single sign-on. Seamless SSO allows users to automatically sign in to Azure AD if they're on their corporate devices connected on their corporate network. When enabled, they don't need to actually even type in their passwords to get into Azure AD. So it actually makes the user experience a whole lot better. This feature is also set up using Azure AD Connect. Now, some organizations may require an authentication feature not currently supported by Azure AD. For example, signing in with smart card authentication or using an on-premises MFA server. In this case, organizations may choose to use Federation. Keep in mind that Azure AD evolves pretty quickly and we add features all the time. So make sure to check the latest documentation before you make your decision. My next example is Woodgrove Bank. Woodgrove Bank is a trusted financial institution that has strong regulatory requirements. They require strong password policies for their bank tellers, and they also require that they don't log on after hours. They're planning to move to Office 365, use some cloud applications, and even some on-premises applications and make them available to tellers and corporate employees. Clearly, Woodgrove Bank cannot use password hash sync because their password policies are different from Azure AD's default policy, and they require support for user logon hours that are not supported by Azure AD natively. Going with Federation could help solve these requirements, but they could lead to higher operational costs in terms of managing servers, certificates, and network configuration. Woodgrove Bank should actually use the modern cloud-first approach of password authentication. Let me explain how password authentication actually works. Password authentication is also set up using Azure AD Connect, just like password hash sync. But instead of synchronizing password hashes to Azure AD, you start by installing two or more authentication agents on premises. You need two or more for high availability. So when I use these agents actually make persistent outbound connections to Azure AD and listen for authentication requests. So when a user signs into Azure AD and they plug in their usernames and passwords, Azure AD actually encrypts the password using a public key, and the username and encrypted password is placed on a queue in the cloud. One of the agents that have been deployed on-prem actually pulls down this username and encrypted password, decrypts the password field using its private key, and tests the username and password against on-premises Active Directory. Now, the result of this authentication, which could be successful, failed, password expired, or user is locked out, is relayed back to Azure AD via the agent. Now, if this authentication is successful, then the user can actually access the application. Now, password authentication also supports smart lockout, but doesn't provide password protection, which is the leak credential report that I just talked about before. Now, password authentication should also be combined with seamless SSO for the best possible user experience. Now, password authentication is the right option for Woodgrow Bank only if they don't need one of the advanced features listed here.
Federation has recommended as an authentication method for organizations that have advanced features not currently supported in Azure AD, including multi-site low latency authentication infrastructure. Federation requires a bit more setup. First, you will need two servers in your internal network to accept authentication requests. More than one server is required for high availability. Next, you will need two or more servers in your perimeter network to accept requests from the internet and then relay those authentication requests to your internal ADFS servers. When a user signs into Azure AD, Azure AD will hand off this authentication request to this trusted federation system that you have configured. This basic topology supports other scenarios such as on-premises MFA servers or smart card authentication. Federated authentication is not just Microsoft's ADFS, but also is for compatible trusted third-party providers. To conclude this video, we want you to consider our top recommendation. Always enable password hash sync. If you use password hash sync and use that for signing, you don't need to worry about high availability. It will be on us. If anything goes wrong with your on-premises service, your authentication will continue to work. But if you choose pass-through authentication or federation, you can still use password hash sync because you can then use that as a backup authentication method. For example, if your on-premises servers goes down, you can manually fail over to password hash sync and still allow your users to sign into cloud apps. Enabling password hash sync also gives you identity protection through the leak credentials reports. This ends our video on choosing the right authentication method for Azure AD in your organization. To learn more, please use these resources on the web. Thank you.